Go to the Tools panel of Photoshop and select the Pen tool. Click on the document and then hold down the Shift. And click again, a bit further along, and you've got this nice straight line. Press Escape so you don't get the rubber band. And then just go up to here to the stroke width. Now it always sets it to a stroke width that I don't want. I want 80. And the reason for 80 is I've got a grid of 80. You can see this grid here, 80 by 80. And that just makes it so much easier to demonstrate how to do this, all the settings. So you've got 80, and if I could put it to 160, of course you can vary it whatever you want. However, Photoshop, preferences, and down to guides and grids. This is in the edit menu for PCs, slightly different. However, you can see now I've got 80 in the setting there. So 80, I could put it to anything else, of course, as well. Also, view and show grid. So once you've done that, you've got 80 there, just go to this option here. And that's the stroke options. And you've got a number of stroke options already available. Obviously, these ones are custom ones I've created. They don't always seem to stay around. I always seem to go to this and find I've lost all my custom options. It's a pity, really, somehow. However, just click one of those. You can see different settings you can get. A variety of different dash designs. But I'm just going to go back to the default setting, this one. Go down to more options. It'd be nice if this was actually available just in this panel because it doesn't add much more. But I want dashed lines. So click there and you get your dashed lines. Now I'm just going to put it to a default of 1 and 1. Just makes it easy. You can see it. And that's for this stage what I'm going to do. I'm going to add some more later. So 1, you can see now this grid is 80 by 80. The stroke is 80, strange enough. You can see it's a square. And the reason I'm going for center, butt and miter. If you go for the other ones, you can go for the other ones. They slightly confuse things. So, butt is the easiest one to demonstrate. So 80 and 80. Now, if I go here, say a gap of 2, you can see now what you get, a gap of obviously 80 times 2, 160. You can do the gap times 3. You can see you get 3 gaps. That's obviously the square, the height, just 3 along. Obviously, I can then go say dash of 2, and you end up with the 3 there, and you also get the dash of 2. Obviously that's extended by 2. And again, if you want 3 by 3, you can see 3 there. So go back to 1 and 3. Well, what you can also do is you can actually go for say 0.5. You don't have to use just 3 or 2 or whatever. You can go for 0.5 and you can see then it becomes 40 pixels. So 40 there, nice gap, half obviously of the stroke width. That's what 0.5 is there. You can set it to 0.25 and you can see it obviously gets thinner there. Likewise, you can put that to 1, back to that, 1, 1, 1 all the way along. And I can go for the dash to be thinner. So 0.5, and that becomes just half of this square, this grid. And again, go that 0.1 to make it thinner. But I'm going to go with 1 and 1 there. What I can now do is I can enter some additional ones here. So gap and gap, I'm going with 1 and 1. I can also use the third one. I'll do that later. So now, instead of gap, I'm going to go with 2 there. And you can see now you've got a gap of 2. So you've got 1, and then you've got 2, and then you've got 1, and then you've got 2. And that's what it's doing, just 1 there and 2. So all the way along, 1 there. Likewise, you can do with the dash. You can set the dash there to be 2. So now you've got that 1, you've got the 1 there, which is that. Then you've got the 2 and 2, which is that. Then back to 1 and 1, and then 2 and 2, 1, and so on. And you can set that to 1 and 1. And now I can set this to 1 and say that to 2. And you can see that's the gap. So you've got 1, 1, and you've of course got a gap of 2 there. So that's that gap, 1 and 1, a gap of 2 again. 1 and 1, and obviously it stops at that point. But again, you can also change this. So you can say that to dash of 2. So again, you've got that one, dash is 1, that dash is 1, so you've got 1 and 1, and now I've got a dash of 2 there, so that's 2, and then 1 and 1, and then 2, 1 and 1, and so on. You can see these settings, and they exactly match this 80 pixels. So if I click there, OK, and I can turn around and say, well, I don't want it to be 80, I want it to be 40. It just reduces down in size. They're all exactly, still keep exactly the same. And again, you can go and set those as well. So if I go over here and say Photoshop, Preferences, and guides grids there and say 80, put it down to 40, not 400, click OK. And you can see then it matches exactly those squares, those settings. And you can go up here and then more options and you can run through it again. You can always clear it. However, it's a pity there's no particular clear feature. It would be nice if you could just clear it, but you could just clear it just by manually going through it like that. You think by now that they've added a clear feature, but there isn't. So one and one again, you can put it to that. Of course, if you're happy with what you've got, say you decide, you know what, I like that one, you can go and save it. So click save and you got it saved. And it's just saved down the bottom. Now you've got a list here. Unfortunately, you can't name anything. Sometimes I've noticed when I've come back to this, it's not there. I don't know. But it's one of those features that never seems to have been upgraded ever. So it would be nice if they updated that. But again, you can see now if you just change that one, two, you don't have to put an entry for the gap. Obviously, it's still just using that one instead. But you can, I think it's just nice to put one and one, just so you're consistent, just so you can see it. But 0.5, and you can just create a variety of different variations. Again, save that as well. And again, you can see it. Unfortunately, for some weird reason, it's very grey with this one. I'm not certain why. You can also delete it as well. So that's a very quick run through of the dashes feature, just for a straight line. Now, of course, what you can do, as with anything in Photoshop, you can use it with other things. So I'm just gonna select, say, there, the rectangle tool, and you can go up here, and you've got all the dash settings there, and you can run through exactly the same sort of settings, just with the values, etc. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.